Hello friends, today we are going to see another name reaction, that is a Reimer-Tiemann reaction. So let's start with the video. So what happened in this? This is a formylation of phenolic hydrocarbon in basic medium. So what happened in this reaction basically? When phenol is treated with chloroform in basic medium, we get formylation at presence of ortho position as well as para position. That is formylation, that is formylation means addition of aldehyde group in presence of chloroform and base, we get addition of aldehyde in ortho position and para position. So let's see what is the mechanism. Actually there are two mechanism in which the first ortho product is formed and meta ortho and para product is formed. I have written here the ortho product here. So what happened, first step, when chloroform and sodium hydroxide, potassium hydroxide treated, then carbene formation is generated. That is when chloroform reacted with base, it will abstract the proton and form CCl3. When one Cl3 removed, it will form CCl2 with carbon having lone pair of electron, which is carbene. So here reactive intermediate is carbene, which is carbene is a neutral reactive species which having one lone pair of electron. So what happened in this? Next, when phenol reacted with that, first phenol reacted with base, you abstract the proton, we will get this type of structure. When what happened, this the abstracted proton, it will create negative charge on the oxygen. This the negative charge will migrate over here, and this double bond will migrate over, then create the negative charge on carbon, that is nucleophilic center. It will attack on this carbene and we get this type of product. Here carbene carbon still having that negative charge, what will happen, it will abstract this proton from this carbon, that is neighboring carbon. At the same time, this bond will get double bond here, and this double bond will migrate over here, and we get this type of compound where carbon is transferred to the hydrogen is transferred to the carbon, and double bond is here we get, and negative charge on this carbon. So next step, what happened, this double bond migrate over here, and this double bond migrate over carbon, and at the same time chlorine will eliminate, and we get one less chlorinated compound. At the same time, what happened in next step, that base will attack as a nucleophile in this carbon, and at the same time that double bond on oxygen will get retained over here and will get negative charge, and this double bond here migrate over here and will get this type of compound. That at the same time three double bond migration happening. First step, that base is acting as nucleophile, attack here carbon, that this double bond will migrate over here, and this double bond migrate on oxygen, which will create negative charge, we can see here. So what happened in next step, this negative charge will migrate over its original position, that is in this. At the same time that double bond is migrate over there, and at the same time chlorine will remove, means what we get, we started with 3 chlorine in chloroform, but in product we doesn't have any chlorine, means that is 3 chlorine is eliminated. And this first, that base has dual role, that is it act as a, this act as a base also and nucleophile also. So what happened is, this double bond have this double bond in carbon, so next step, what happened, this double bond will migrate toward oxygen and it will create negative charge, and this double bond migrate over here, and that that oxygen have one lone pair, which migrate over here and create the aldehyde, and this oxygen get negative charge, abstract the proton from here, we get ortho substituted ortho salicylaldehyde for para salicylaldehyde. But means in this step only, that its migration is taking one more bond step, like this oxygen migrate over there, and this carbon bond will migrate over here, and this will attack on carbon. Instead of ortho carbon, para carbon will attack, and we get para substituted aldehyde, that is salicylaldehyde. So there is one reaction also, when this para methyl substituted phenol reacted is same, we get as usual that we get aldehyde substituted in ortho position as well as we get that is unexpected product. Here what happened, that is carbene is attached here, that is para position. So what happened this thing? So we have this ortho product will form which follow this mechanism, but for this product the mechanism is like that. So what happened, this will react with base to abstract the proton, it will abstract the proton. So what happened in next step, this oxygen migrate over to position, and at the same time this double bond migrate over here, and ortho carbon with respect to phenol will attack to carbene. And the next step what happened, we get quinone structure like this, where oxygen having double bond with carbon, this double bond, this double bond, and this carbene will still having that negative charge. So what happened, it will abstract the proton from this carbon atom, it will stabilize CsCl2. So we get this type of compound. So next compound is a alpha naphthol, where alpha naphthol reacted with chloroform and potassium hydroxide, we get as usual the ortho substituted benzaldehyde, ortho substituted aldehyde. Like beta naphthol also reacted with this, that is beta naphthol reacted like chloroform and base, that is potassium hydroxide, we get ortho substituted aldehyde. So next is a methoxy, ortho methoxy substituted phenol reacted with this, the same reagent is used, where we get para substituted, not ortho substituted, because of the steric hindrance. So next is a hydroxycumarine. So this is subjected to also to Reimer-Tiemann reaction, where chloroform and base is there, it will also get the ortho substituted, ortho formaldehyde, that is aldehyde substituted compound. So here pyrrole is reacted with same condition, we get general compounds, general product, that is formylation taking place, ortho substitution, but along with that there is unexpected product, means ring expansion taking place along with their halogenated pyridine. We can see this product is halogenated pyridine. So what happened for this, for there what happened, that this double bond and this double bond will form like triangular, and this will form a cyclopropane ring. So this carbon will attack here and will form CCl2, that is CCl2 triangular ring, that is cyclopropane ring. Next step what happened, this nitrogen on lone pair will migrate here, and this ring opens, so we get 6 membered ring. Here at that time chlorine also eliminate, we get 6 membered ring where nitrogen carrying positive charge. So what happened, this base abstract this proton and we get halogenated pyridine. So here also indole will react, indole also reacted with same reagents, that same condition, we also get same type of compound like ortho. Here we get meta substituted compound, and here we also get that pyridine, like pyridine structure, that chlorination is. So next is a phenol. So in presence of, when phenol is treated with tetrachlorocarbon, means CCl4 in presence of base, like Reimer-Tiemann reaction, formylation not taking place, instead of acidification taking place in ortho position. So what happened in this mechanism is there. So what happened, the first step, proton abstract this phenolic proton, so form O minus. So what happened, this O minus will migrate over, and this carbon will attack, this nucleophilic carbon attack on carbon, so we'll get. And the usual mechanism follow mostly the Reimer-Tiemann mechanism. Here in presence of chloroform we get for aldehyde, but in presence of CCl4 we get acid. This is the difference, like changing just reactant condition will get different type of product. I mean, in presence of one CCl4 we get acid at ortho position, if chloroform is used, what happened, that formaldehyde, that's salicyldehyde, aldehydic substitution happened. So this is all about the Reimer-Tiemann reaction. If you have any doubt or query, you can comment down in comment section. If you like this video, please like it, share it and subscribe it. Thank you.